Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab, covering ways to improve SNR and THD measurements in the characterization of data converters. Precision Labs is a comprehensive online curriculum for analog engineers. More videos can be found by going to ti.com/precisionlabs. This video introduces a measurement technique called coherent sampling. This technique is a method that can be used to get the best possible ADC characterization results. In other words, coherent sampling eliminates error sources related to the discrete nature of the FFT and allows characterization of high-performance data converters. Also covered in this lab is a test method that uses an external filter to reduce noise and distortion on the input signal to a level where it allows for accurate characterization of the data converter. Here we go through an example of a data converter characterization system. Let's step through the math as we did in the TI Precision Labs video titled Fast Fourier Transforms, FFTs, and Windowing. Here, the sampling rate is 1 megasample per second, and 256 samples are taken. This information is used to find the frequency resolution. The input frequency is 62.5 kHz, so dividing the input frequency by the frequency resolution shows that the frequency bin is the exact integer 16. Since the input frequency is an exact integer multiple of the frequency resolution, we have no spectral leakage. This is called coherent sampling. Based on this information, it seems like a good ADC characterization method is to adjust the input frequency to an integer multiple of the frequency resolution so that we have coherent sampling. Unfortunately, that isn't generally so practical, as we will see in the next slide. The reality of most equipment is that the signal generator output frequency and microcontroller clock frequency do not have the accuracy and stability to facilitate coherent sampling. Notice that the sine wave generator is adjusted to 62.5 kHz, but the actual output frequency is 62.503 kHz. Furthermore, the output frequency of this generator drifts with time and temperature. A similar phenomena exists with the microcontroller clock rate. Ideally, the sampling rate is set to 1 megasamples per second, but in reality, it is at 0.9997 MHz and will drift with time and temperature. The end result, when you work through the math, is that we no longer have coherent sampling, and the FFT will have spectral leakage. So this simple method cannot be used for coherent sampling. In the next slide, we will see how a more sophisticated system can be used to achieve coherent sampling. One way to achieve coherent sampling in a practical system is to synchronize the frequency of the microcontroller with the signal generator. Thus, the error in the microcontroller sampling rate will track and cancel the error in the function generator so that the input frequency will always remain an integer multiple of the frequency resolution even when the clock drifts. So the clock from the microcontroller is also applied to a sync input on the signal generator. Even though synchronizing the signal generator to the microcontroller theoretically solves the coherent sampling issue, high-precision PLL clock generators and high-end signal generators are typically used in this kind of characterization, as clock jitter and drift will introduce additional error. Also note that this kind of characterization is normally required for high-resolution converters with resolutions of 18 bits or higher. Another important consideration in ADC characterization is the purity of the input signal. Many common signal generators have resolutions of 12 bits or less. These devices do not have the THD and SNR capable of testing high-performance SAR converters. Some high-end signal generators may have very good THD and SNR, but these can be expensive and may not be available in your lab. One approach to getting high-fidelity signals from a common signal generator is to use a band-pass filter at the output of the signal generator. The example figure shows that the output of the signal generator has a relatively high noise floor and significant harmonics. Notice that the function generator is adjusted to generate a 1 kHz sine wave. This sine wave is applied to a bandpass filter with a center frequency of 1 kHz. The passband on the filter will pass the fundamental, and the stop bands will significantly attenuate the noise and harmonics. Normally, a high-order filter is used to maximize the attenuation of noise and harmonics. Using this method, it is possible to generate an input signal sufficient for testing an 18 to 20-bit converter using a common signal generator. This slide shows an example of the FFT feature on our evaluation modules. Notice that SNR, THD, SINAD, and other AC performance metrics are displayed with the FFT. Also, you can zoom in on the first 9 harmonics as shown here. The number of samples can be adjusted, and generally, increasing the number of samples will reduce the impact of spectral leakage. However, taking more samples will increase the measurement time. For very long measurement times, the signal generator output frequency may drift, which will have an impact on SNR. For best performance, 16,000 to 32,000 samples is often used. However, this number may be different depending on the device and the test equipment used. Also notice that the type of window can be adjusted. In general, the 7-term Blackman-Harris is the best choice. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content.